The Frankie Files.
So when I was listening to your interview on the Cult Vault podcast, one of the things I took away from that exchange with Katie was that you felt an experience of being coerced. Can you tell us about that?
The thing that really like blew my mind was there was a tape where I was talking to Katie and she was asking me all this stuff about my personal life. And I was just kind of like unloading stuff about my personal life. And then like right after that, I was saying something like, you know, I really feel like this, all this happening right now and meeting you, and this is God. And, you know, this is, and I am not I'm an atheist.
Okay.
And then I just sort of remembered, like, I had this memory of like standing in this yard in Duluth, Minnesota, and watching like the wind blow through the leaves and thinking like, this is God. And I was talking to Katie, was like the only person I was talking to about this, but yeah. She had sort of put that in my head, like, you know, like all this stuff that's going on, like it's outside of your control, you know, and it made sense. And I've heard that kind of stuff before. I was raised Catholic. You know, there's a pattern to everything, and there's a path that God is going to send you on. But that was the only time in my life that I really believed that. And then I stopped thinking that when it slowly receded after I stopped talking to Katie.
It was a trick.
And that definitely really changed the calculus of what I wanted to do, and publishing stuff about this cult and bringing them down was that it was me and Katie had a personal relationship. We were friends. We talked about all kinds of stuff. There was just really uncomfortable stuff to listen back on in there. That was where it was kind of like, yeah, this is just like something I'm going to do now. A couple of years after that, me and Katie got back in touch. She was out of the cult, and we had a couple conversations sort of going back into this story that Mark, the leader, like knew my girlfriend at the time's name.
Oh, shoot.
From when I was talking to Katie. There was something weird on the internet that I thought like was some troll that was like posting things, and I just had to ask her. I was like, but like, why would it ever be an important detail, like in my personal life?
She was feeding him info.
Yeah, exactly.
That's spooky. Yeah, it was really get spooky. You.
That sort of collecting of information, like a lot of cults do this. I mean, like, cults are blackmail machines. Blackmail machines.
Blackmail machines. Blackmail machines.